Hi, today I'm going to show you how to make Poe apps, why you should make them, and how you can make money with Poe apps. I use Poe apps a lot. I turn a lot of the prompts that I use repeatedly into bots, so it saves me time. Here you can see that I have a newsletter generator, I have an N8N generator, I have a prompt generator, so I have all these bots that help me save time. But at the same time, I can also share them out and make some money with it when someone else uses my bot. Here you see that I have a newsletter generator. All I need to do is plug in the topic, the audience, the resources, and it'll generate an email for me that I can send out every week. So this is one use case of a Poe bot. But it's also really interesting that you can make money with Poe bots. Here are some statistics I collected from other creators. Some of them have made $2,000, some have made $1,000, $700. So it's real. People are making real money with Poe bots. The beauty of Poe bots is that the return on investment is really high. It takes 5 to 10 minutes to make a bot, and maybe you can make $1,000 as opposed to spending weeks making a mobile app, launching an app store, and then accepting payments. That's just a lot of work. So the ROI is very high for Poe bots. So I collected some real data from some friends and some creators, and this is what you're looking at. You need at least 7 to 8,000 users to generate, $750. If you have more than 200,000 users, then you can make maybe $2,000. Not only do you need a lot of users, but the frequency of use is also important. If you have something that people use every day and they send a lot of messages, you also earn more money. So the key to making money with Poe bots is to make a bot that a lot of people use and they have to use very frequently. How it makes money is every time someone sends a message, you can charge them a fee, which you can set, and you get paid per use for your bot. Another way to make money is if people who don't have a Poe paid account use your bot and they find the bot so useful that they have to upgrade to a paid account, you'll get a referral fee for them signing up as well. But in this scenario, I'm just talking about bots where people use it a lot and they charge them every time and you get a cut. So let's walk through on how you can create a Poe bot. All you need to do is go to Poe, sign up for an account, come here, click on create. Most of these are very self-explanatory. You got prompt, image, video. So this is like text-based, you have a task, you want to output something with a prompt. Roleplay is more difficult where you have to supply some knowledge to the bot so then they can pretend to be someone where you can chat with. And the only major difference is, the server bot and the canvas bot. I'm not going to go into server bot today. Canvas bot is a more complicated app, and I'll go into explaining what a canvas app is. So you have image generation, video, server, and roleplay. All these can be done purely with just a text prompt that you supply to the bot, secret prompt. And all these bots allow you to have monetization where you can set a price, and basically is a chat interface. One line, you type in text and you get something back, or you upload something and you get something back. Canvas app is basically a rich app interface. It would actually generate an HTML looking website with lots of fields, buttons, and all sorts of funky stuff. If you need a complicated app like that, then go with a Canvas app. But the downside is, at this stage, you cannot make any money with Canvas app. All right, so in this video, we're just gonna go into the beginner basics of making a simple prompt bot. I'll make another video on how to make a Canvas app. But right now, let's look into the most basic prompt bot. You come in, and what you need to generate is you need a picture, you need a name. The name is really important, because that's how people are gonna discover you. The secret is to name the names so that when people search for it, it matches their intent, right? So the better the name you have that matches the intent, the better. And right now, the earlier you get on, the better the name you're gonna get, because once someone has taken a name, then you gotta come up with a new name. And so a lot of the good names are already taken, so the earlier you come on, the better. You have to write a description so then it attracts people to actually try your bot. Then you have to come down here and choose your LLM model. So it depends on what you want to do. If you want to go text, you can choose all these models. But if you want image, you probably need an LLM that supports image generation. There's also like a caveat, the faster and more powerful the LLM you choose, the more credits it will consume. So this will add to your costs. And then this is the most important part, where you come up with a prompt that makes this bot useful. And then you can add in a knowledge base. If there's any documents or some writing or whatever that supplements your bot, like training knowledge. For example, if I have a list of all the veterinary clinics in an area, I can upload the veterinary clinics here, and then the prompt can be simply to search my knowledge base for the location of the nearest veterinary clinic. When you first open the bot, you'll be greeted with a greeting message, and you basically want people, you want to guide people to input the right prompt to use your bot. You can make it as publicly accessible, related recommendations, but the most important is how much you want to set for your message earnings. What I would do is I would look at comparable bots in your niche and see how much they're charging. It's USD per 1,000 messages, so anywhere between $5 to $10 is like a good starting point, but you can always add on more. And then once you've inputted all that, you can hit publish. You're saying, hey, Keith, that's a lot of things to input. Well, that's why I created something. That's why I created a bot that allows you to generate the name, the description, the prompt, and the greeting message just by inputting your idea, and I'll show you how it looks like. So I created a Poe app creator where all you need to do is type in your idea. And then if you can put in a target audience, the problem is solved, and key features. If you don't put it in, it's fine. And then click generate app components, and it'll generate everything you need to create a Poe app. And I've created a bunch of apps already that is generating revenue using this, and it takes 2 minutes. But before you start, the most important question is, Keith, I don't have any ideas. What should I create? Well, it's really simple. Actually, ChatGPT already has bots called GPTs. And what you can do is you can go there and look for their top most popular ideas. And if it doesn't exist in Poe, you can just copy it. Here you see that in lifestyle, there's find my celebrity lookalike, upload a photo of yourself and see which celeb you look like. Maybe we can do that. Let's do that. Okay, so I've typed in find my celebrity lookalike, upload a photo of yourself and see which celeb you look like. Let's see what it does. Okay, here you will see that it's generated the prompt, the app name, description, greeting message, app icon. And if I don't like the app icon, I can generate a new variation. Try copying the prompt and generating. So copy and paste the prompt into the prompt. Copy the name, copy description, so because I'm taking an image, I probably need something that supports image, and so this one does it, as you see by the icon indicated with an image at the bottom. Copy the greeting message. Download the icon, and then I need to put in, let's say it's $5, and then I hit publish. So the name is unavailable. Let's try a different one. Okay, so I've generated it, and now I just need to upload a clear photo of myself. So here's a photo of myself. Uploading and see what celebrity I match. Okay, this is good. So it's saying there's a problem. It's a full body pose. I need a more clear picture of my face. So that's a good start. Let's find another photo. Okay, I found another photo. Let's upload it. Ha! So it's saying it looks like Henry Golding. So this is a... If you don't know who Henry Golding is, let's take a look. So this is Henry Golding. It's not a bad celebrity match. Now, there's a lot of improvements I can do to the Poe Bot. There's a lot of ways to improve this bot. I can make it return a picture of Henry Golding if I want and change a prompt to do that. But you can see how fast you can create a Poe Bot. If you've liked this video, please like and subscribe. And you can check out the Poe app creator in the link below. And if you want more tips on AI like this one, join my community in the link below.